Hi out there, this is Oliver Busse with another video showing you how to use the Bootstrap 3 template I just published on GitHub, as you may have noticed. The Bootstrap 3 template is a starter kit to create your own applications with a Bootstrap 3 layout, some navigation elements and about boxes and stuff. In this video I will show you the whole process from downloading from GitHub, setting up a project in Domino Designer, creating an NSF from it and customizing the application. First step is to navigate to my GitHub repository, locate the Bootstrap 3 template repository and download the zip file. I save it on my local disk, just on my desktop. Open a file explorer. Unzip it to a folder. And the folder contains the on-disk project. So I open it up and I copy that file path. I go to Domino Designer, open up the navigator, import an existing project into my workspace, paste the root directory. Bootstrap master ODP. I have an issue here still because my project is already existing in my local workspace, so I have to tweak the project file that is created by Eclipse, and I have to rename the project to another name, demo for example, and I repeat that, and now this name is showed up and the project is imported here. As you can see, this was my problem. I have a project already in my workspace with that name, so I have to adapt that name a little. Okay, next step is to create a new application. To create a new application from the just downloaded source project on my disk, I right click on the imported project and say team development associate with new NSF, not with existing but with a new NSF. I put it on my local server, BS3 template demo NSF. BS3 demo. Finish. The import process may take some time, seconds, minutes. And I open the application right here from the designer, and this is a just created database, BS3 demo. I open it in Domino Designer, put it to my workspace, and here we are. We have some X pages, we have custom controls, we have also some Java code here and JavaScript library, and of course we have, if I switch to the package explorer, we have the bootstrapped CK editor resources also right here. And if you look in the XSP properties, in the page generation, there are some plugins activated some extensions, the extension library, of course, the Bootstrap for X pages library. This is needed by this template, and the activated OpenNTF Domino API. So if I just switch to my browser and type localhost and VS3-Template NSF. Oh no, it's misspelled, I think. Demo. It's called demo, not template. I should see a database. Maybe I have to tweak the ACL. This may also take some time for the first time. But here we are. By default, the ACL is set to manager for all users, and the anonymous user is set to, I think, editor access. Can show you that. Access control. Anonymous user is editor. Yes. Okay. So this is the starter kit, and it comes with some samples. The default Bootstrap samples from the Bootstrap page, and also an implementation of the Bootstrapped CK editor. It looks quite different from that default one, and I now want to show you how to customize. We have some navigation elements here. Two I just used before to navigate to the samples and the Bootstrap CK editor page. There's also a link to the starting page. This is the red one. We have copyright noticed here. If you click on it, you receive an about box. This is the custom control. Also, you want to tweak a little bit, and we have a login button here that directs me to the login page if you want to use your application with a logged in user. If you click cancel, you are redirected straight to the starting page. Here's another link in the bottom line. It's called subpage. This is a dead link. This is also this is only a hash link here. So how to tweak and customize this template to fit to your own application? It's quite simple. So we just have to look at the Java part of the application. There are four Java classes implemented here. The highlighted one here is the email validator. Is just a helper class. If you have a form on an X page where you have a field, the user has to type an email address in. Use this validator to validate the email address if it's correctly spelled and formatted. There's also a pre-configured faces config here, and the validator is just defined here at the bottom, and the ID of the validator for that email addresses is called email validator. So if you have a look at my OSnippets homepage, you can find an sample implementation of that email validator, or even on XSnippets, this validator is also published. There are two other beans defined in this faces config here. One is the navigation bean and the footer bean, pointing to the navigation footer Java class. And these beans are the keys to the navigation items you will receive on the top navigation bar and on the bottom navigation bar. So first we have a look at the navigation footer, as it is a simple one of both. There's a lot of stuff here, but this is a key part here. There is a page defined called subpage. This is one of the links in the bottom nav bar, and this only points to nothing. So if you want to define other pages here, just copy that line, customize the label, the URL. The third parameter is to define an icon, a glyph icon from the Bootstrap CSS framework. So I just save the project and refresh the page, and the new link should appear at the bottom navbar soon. And here we are. This is another link pointing also to nothing. Okay, this is the footer navigation items. The last parameter I have to name, you may know that know this from other videos I did. The last parameter is to define whether to open the page in a new window or not. As this is using the page class, you also want to have a look at the page class itself. And here you can see this parameter, this boolean defines if the link is open in a new window or tab or not. Okay, closing that navigation footer, opening the navigation. And here you can see the real working stuff from the sample template. Here are two navigation items defined pointing to the samples XSP and the BSC CKE XSP page, both using the icon definition. And you can easily customize the icons by naming another class. No, this is not a star anymore. This is the house icon. You can find the whole spec of any icons that can be used in the documentation from Bootstrap 3 on the components page. And here are the glyph icons explained. And if I want to use another one, I just go here and copy that string and replace the whole term with a new one. And now I want to have a cloud to appear near this link. Et voila. Okay. So if you want to add another page to your application, just do it. I call mine test XSP, and the core component is the layout. Just drag the layout here, and there are some facets available here. The facet left, the facet right, the facet middle. This is the main content. The facet left is not used at this time. You may want to adapt it. In the basic layout, I only use the content and the right sidebar. And the thing that is called facet help is the area beneath the top navigation bar. After placing the custom control, the layout BS3 custom control, you can have a look at some custom properties. Both are optional. You can fill it if you want. If you do not define them, nothing happens, except that you won't have a page title here displayed, and the default color of the facet help area is dark gray. Of course, it is defined in the custom control what's the default color. If you want to specify another color here, you can do that. I love this color picker to find a cool color here, and I will choose a green one, green yellow one. I copy the color code, and you have to declare the color code CSS style with a hash prefix, and I also define a page title here, saving it and reload. You can see the page title is displayed now, and the color is also displayed. next step would be to add some help in the help area, as it is called help area. I would assume the help text here. Some text, images, don't bother. The area is adapting its height automatically to the to its content. There is a min height here defined, but you can put a lot more lines or stuff inside that area. For the content itself, I also would suggest you to create a div element within the facet middle, where you can place your whole stuff in it, other custom controls, your forms, actions and stuff. And here we are. Last one is the right facet right area, where you can define elements for the sidebar. I like the usage of the Bootstrap panels with panel header and panel footer, as they look quite decent. Last step would be for this demo to add an item in the top navigation bar to navigate to this newly created X page. Of course, I open the navigation class again, copy that stuff, test, leave that icon alone, name the X page, save it, refresh the page. Well, we have another entry here that we can navigate to. As you can see, the entry is automatically highlighted with a class from the Bootstrap framework, CSS. Nothing special about it. Yes, I hope you enjoyed this little video and of course the template. I want to point to other templates I developed and published them on GitHub. Beside the Bootstrap 3 template, which is of course the most popular at the moment, I did other templates based on other toolkits and other frameworks. I have a foundation based template here. Can't find it here in my bookmarks. The foundation template is quite similar to the Bootstrap template. Navigation items on the top navbar, there is no bottom navbar. And I also have a UI kit template. UI kit is another framework, CSS and JavaScript framework, that is very, very similar to the Bootstrap one. The screenshot in the GitHub repository does not look like that promising, so I show you the live demo of the UI kit I have here on my server. So you can see the top navigation bar similar to behavior of the links when they are activated, and the screenshot you see in the repository is actually the login screen, which is exactly the same as it is in the Bootstrap template. But this template uses the so-called UI kit framework. It's available from the URL getuikit.com. This is what the page looks like. And I have to say that this framework is made in Germany. Yes. Okay. Feel free to contact me if you have any questions, troubles. Feel free to contribute to the projects on GitHub, and see you later.